One thing I'm looking forward to in the month of January of 2020 is, of course, the Nintendo Direct we're going to get. Now, you might be sitting there thinking, well, Nintendo hasn't announced a Nintendo Direct for the month of January. RGT, is this clickbait? And I'd be like, no, it's not. Like, more than likely, we are getting a Nintendo Direct in the month of January. I'm 99.9% sure we are getting a Nintendo Direct. I am so confident that if we don't get a Nintendo Direct in January, I will eat a leaf off of Mitch.
Don't touch me, you freaking weirdo.
Don't worry, Mitch. I won't have to touch you because we are getting a Nintendo Direct in the month of January. Not only does it make sense from a timeline standpoint of just how many games Nintendo has to talk about for 2020, but whenever Nintendo does an Indie World presentation, it is always followed up within about a month or so with a Nintendo Direct. So I'm very confident in talking about a Nintendo Direct for the month of January, but you gotta remember, we don't really know a hell of a lot of what is going to happen for the Nintendo Switch in 2020. So I thought it would be fun to do some predictions of what I expect to see in this first Nintendo Direct for 2020. So sit back, relax, make sure you subscribe to the channel, and let's get into some January Nintendo Direct predictions for 2020. So I'm gonna start this off with some softball stuff, some stuff that, you know, everyone expects to happen, and I think stuff that makes sense, and then we'll get a bit crazier as the video goes on. Now, I'm not saying I have any inside information on any of this stuff. This is just my sort of speculation based on things I've seen and based on trends within Nintendo themselves. I think first and foremost, a Smash Brothers character direct is a foregone conclusion at this point in time. A lot of people expected there to be a Smash Brothers character unveiled at the Game Awards 2019, myself included, and then Nintendo was just like, no, we're just gonna go to the after show and get drunk and hang out, because Nintendo pretty much no-showed the Game Awards 2019 when it comes to game announcements and, of course, Smash Brothers updates. Now, there is one final character in Season 1 of Smash Brothers to be unveiled. Now, as far as who that character is, I honestly have no idea. I know there's a lot of Smash Brothers channels out there that have all this sort of speculation and all sorts of things going on. There's a weird character from Xenogears that's being talked about as potentially coming to Smash now. I think it's all a bunch of rubbish when it comes down to it. I don't think anyone truly knows who this next Smash Brothers character is going to be, but I do think it's going to be an impactful character. When you look at all of the characters that have been revealed via DLC, there's been a lot of differentiating characters. You, of course, had Terry, Banjo, you had Joker from Persona. It's just a crazy thing, and you really don't know who is going to be that next character. But one thing I do know is there will be another character unveiling, and more than likely, it will be at this January 2020 Direct. Another thing I think will be a somewhat focal point for the January 2020 Nintendo Direct is, of course, going to be Animal Crossing. That is really Nintendo's first big game of 2020 for the Nintendo Switch. Yes, there's Tokyo Mirage Sessions also coming out on the Nintendo Switch, but that is coming out in January. People pretty much know what to expect with that game. It is an enhanced port of the game that released on the Wii U. There's some additional content in there as well. Evidently, there's some no vagina bones or something. I don't know. That's a whole weird rabbit hole that I'm not going down into. Just Google it and you get into this whole weird thing. But of course, Animal Crossing is a centerpiece. Obviously, that's going to be a very big game for Nintendo, and it's a big game for Nintendo in general, no matter the platform that it is going to be on. This is really the first time we've seen a big, dedicated Animal Crossing in quite a while when it comes to home consoles. The last one that we got was, of course, on the Wii. So I feel like Animal Crossing definitely has evolved, and there's a lot of new stuff that they have shown so far of Animal Crossing, but I still feel like there's a whole hell of a lot of other stuff going on in there. I almost have a sneaking suspicion there's going to be some sort of stuff like we saw in the original GameCube version of Animal Crossing, maybe with some virtual console stuff. I think that would be really cool, to be honest with you. I think you could do a lot with that. You know, maybe have some games that aren't even available in Nintendo's online app for the SNES and the NES currently, and have them dedicated to just Animal Crossing. Yeah, it might piss some people off, but it would also give people an incentive to check out this game, because that was one of my favorite things about the original Animal Crossing. I feel like you're going to get a whole bunch of new mechanics, a whole bunch of new things to do, and they're going to sort of talk more about the online aspect, because it really seems like there's going to be a big community aspect with Animal Crossing. And that game, like I said, it comes out in March of 2020, so you really need to start ramping it up and really getting the hype ramped up for that. Tokyo Mirage Sessions, yeah, it'll probably be in there. They'll probably talk about it a little bit, but I definitely think Animal Crossing is going to be a big focal point when it comes to this Nintendo Direct. So really, those are the two things things that I am confident we will see in this Nintendo Direct, and everything else is pretty much just up in the air. And that's almost a bit exciting to me. I really like just sort of speculating on things that we know about, things we might not know about, and things that might end up happening at this Direct. So really the rest of this is just going to be simply speculation, just based on trends that we've seen with Nintendo, and just sort of how some of these games are maybe getting along further in development than we are thinking of. So first and foremost, I think you're going to get Bayonetta 3 at this. I really expected Bayonetta 3 to be at the Game Awards 2019. It just sort of made sense to me. It's one of those games that has cross appeal. It has that sort of mass appeal as well. But maybe Platinum didn't want to talk about that game because during that same week, they talked about that game that's coming out on the PS4 that's a collaboration with Square Enix. The name sort of passes me by right now. I don't recall the name of it. I'll have some gameplay footage up on the screen right now. But I thought it kind of looked a bit bland. You know, it didn't really have a really good color palette. I thought the gameplay itself looked really nice, but it's a game I'm interested in seeing more of because I really do enjoy Platinum Games games, but I feel like Bayonetta 3 would have overshadowed that, and I definitely think Bayonetta 3 is pretty far along in development. The game was announced quite a while ago. Of course, we got the Bayonetta 1 and 2 collection already released on the Nintendo Switch, so I think Bayonetta 3 is going to be a 2020 game, and I think there's a very good chance that Bayonetta 3 will finally see some gameplay from it, at least a teaser for this game, but I definitely think it's time to start talking about Bayonetta 3, and I definitely foresee Platinum Games and Nintendo revealing it in a Nintendo Direct. Another thing I think Nintendo might talk about during this Nintendo Direct is just more information on the Nintendo Switch's online service. I feel like when they introduced the Super Nintendo games, that was definitely a big deal. But since then, since the introduction of these games, they've pretty much just not gone with the monthly program that they had been doing when it was previously just NES games. And now people are kind of like, well, when did the new games come? Do we really just need to rely on Nintendo to just sort of stealth drop these games a couple days before they announce it? Or will there be a more concrete schedule? I think Nintendo might want to release a concrete schedule for this. I think it just sort of makes sense. And I honestly think there might be another exclusive game that is at least talked about, potentially even shadow dropped during this Nintendo Direct for the Nintendo Switch's online service. The last game we got for it was Tetris 99. And Tetris 99 was admittedly a very big deal. A lot of people love that game. It's still a very popular game. It was so popular that they ended up doing a physical release for the game. Like, it was just absolutely crazy how this game just sort of made Nintendo Switch owners want to pick up the Nintendo Switch's online service. I definitely think it's time to introduce another exclusive game. I don't really know what that game could be. I guess you could sort of go the puzzle route, maybe another Dr. Mario game for the Nintendo Switch's online service and have it as just, you know, a complimentary thing for signing up for the service. I think that would be really cool. Or you could just go in the complete opposite direction and do something just completely unique. But I definitely think Nintendo needs to talk about Nintendo Switch Online because even though they have introduced the Super Nintendo stuff into it, which made it a bit of a better value, they definitely need to talk about it more, and they still need to add more stuff to it. And I think a stealth game, or at least a brand new game that's going to be available for Nintendo Switch Online owners, would be a good thing to do. Now, as far as third-party companies are concerned, I'm not quite sure what to expect. I think there's a good chance you could see actual gameplay footage of Bravely Default 2. Obviously, that game was unveiled at the Game Awards 2019, but there wasn't any sort of gameplay footage. It was mostly artwork, then you got the sort of shot of the characters at the end of the trailer, and then that was pretty much it. I feel like this game is probably a bit further in development than Square Enix is letting on, so I definitely think you could potentially see some gameplay footage of this game running on the Nintendo Switch, and maybe even get some additional information on the features, what's going to be different, what the cast of characters is going to be, is the battle system going to be the same as the 3DS games, or are they going to differentiate it, improve it, make it for more home console style gaming? I'm not quite sure, but I definitely think Bravely Default 2 has a good chance of showing up at this Nintendo Direct. Another thing I think you're going to see are more ports, because ports seem to be doing really well on the Nintendo Switch, and now you have so many different companies that can handle ports and do just phenomenal jobs with these games that probably shouldn't be running on the Nintendo Switch. I think you gotta look at companies like Panic Button. You gotta look at companies like Virtuos. You gotta look at companies like Feral Interactive, who have brought these huge experiences that many people thought would not be available on the Nintendo Switch to the system and have done them a damn good job of it. Of course, Panic Button is probably tied up a bit with Doom Eternal, but I mean, they could still be potentially working on something else. Barrel Interactive has done Grid and Alien Isolation. I feel like they are moving on to something else. And Virtuos, you never know what Virtuos is doing. You never know what Virtuos is working on, really. So I definitely think you're going to see some really big ports of third-party games during this Nintendo Direct presentation that's happening in January. And finally, will Metroid be at this January Nintendo Direct? No, there's not going to be any Metroid. I just feel like Metroid is a long ways away. I think Metroid could end up showing up at E3 2020 with some gameplay footage. I feel like by then they'll have, you know, a good grasp of what's going on with this. But as far as Metroid showing up during a January Nintendo Direct, I don't think so. Also, I don't think you're going to see any Breath of the Wild stuff either, because when Nintendo talks about games, they usually talk about them 6 months to a year from when they're going to be released. And if you talk about Breath of the Wild 2, I have that pegged as a holiday 2020 game. So you would really be stretching that sort of year-long thing with The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild 2. Now, I do think Breath of the Wild 2 is very far in development, but I also feel like it might sort of overshadow what Nintendo is trying to do with this Nintendo Direct, because I honestly feel like there's going to be a lot of surprises. Maybe even stuff that we haven't even been thinking about. Maybe even games that haven't been announced, or maybe games that people have forgotten about. Maybe some information on Shin Megami Tensei. Maybe some more information on the Xenoblade remake that's coming. I think Nintendo really has a lot of stuff up their sleeve, but they just are waiting for 2020 to start to really come out of the gate, because it needs to be a strong year for Nintendo. With the PS5 and the Xbox Series X coming out in holiday 2020, you gotta get people's mindset set on Nintendo, and the best way to do that is with games. So I feel like you're gonna see a lot of games during this Nintendo Direct, and you'll probably see some surprises as well. So those are just my basic predictions of what I expect to see during this Nintendo Direct for the month of January. Like I said, I'm 99.9% sure that we will see this Direct. I will eat a leaf off of Mitch if we do not see this Direct. So yeah, you know, I don't want to eat my housemate. Like, that wouldn't be very cool. So let me know in the comment section down below what you think of this. Do you think that these games will be at the January Nintendo Direct? And if not, what games do you expect to be there? And as always, guys, thank you for checking out this video. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe and turn on notifications. Be sure to check out my social medias and stuff like that. Make sure you're following me on there. Check out the pinned comment in the comment section down below if you want to get some RGT merch, or even pick up the Complete 32X guide, because that's a really cool book and people like books. I like books. You should like books. And as always, I'll catch you guys on the next video. Later.